How to perform paired sample t-test, also referred to as dependent sample t-test. So in dependent sample or in paired sample t-test, we can be able to visualize this is how I have entered the data. So if you don't know how to enter the data in SPSS, kindly watch the video in the description, which show you how to enter data in SPSS. So these contain data of hormone before and hormone after. This is how this is why it is called dependent. Of some patient who are injected with a certain hormone boost, so this is the hormone before and this is hormone after. So these are try to show us if they have a certain efficiency in the hormone or in that vaccine which they were injected with. So in order to test, to do the test and do some interpretation, we need to click the option analyze, and then come to where we have compare means. We come to here, we have paired sample t-test. So the first pair was the hormone before, and our second pair was the hormone after. Then we shall click OK, and the data set will be generated here. So this is our output. So our output, in order to know if there was significant difference, the mean of the hormone before was 88.94 and the mean of the hormone after was 82.16. So but what we need to check a lot, which gives us the last conclusion, is the significance. Can you see here where you have significance? There is 75% chance that the mean of the hormone before and the mean of the hormone after are the same. So since we are doing this configuration using 95% confidence level, so if there is 75% probability that these mean are the same, so what should we conclude? We are concluding an null hypothesis that there is no difference between the mean of the hormone before and hormone after. So we shall reject that vaccine automatically, since it is not boosting or it's not having a significant hormonal boost. What also tells us we shall adopt a null hypothesis is here, where we have the tail, the upper tail and the lower tail. So if there exists a zero between the upper tail and the lower tail, so the zero, if it is exists here, it tells us automatically we shall adopt a null hypothesis, which signifies that there is no difference between the mean before and the mean after. So since we are trying to test the efficiency of that vaccine, maybe it's Johnson & Johnson, I've read the results, it's not boosting anything. So since we have 75% chance that there is no difference between the mean of the hormone before and hormone after, since they were depending on the same vaccine or the hormonal boost or the same substance which was supposed to do some hormonal boost, but the hormonal booster is actually the same. So thank you for watching. Kindly don't forget to watch the next video which I'm creating on parametric test, with also some bit of where we shall compare more than three means, which is called ANOVA and MANOVA. We shall do that parametric test, so you get the link in the description as time goes. So don't forget to give the video a thumbs up. Bon appetit. Thank you.